How to treat cervical kyphosis with corrective chiropractic care. That's the focus of this video. If you've been told you have a cervical kyphosis, whether it's on your x-ray or maybe an MRI, talked about it, an MRI report, then this video is for you. What I'm gonna show you in this video is I'm gonna take you through my entire corrective care protocol that we apply for our patients to help restore a cervical kyphosis. We're gonna look at the exercise that we do. We're gonna look at the adjustments that we do for cervical kyphosis. We're also gonna look at the traction exercise that we do in office and at home for cervical kyphosis. So stay tuned. So let me just show you in a spine model first what we're dealing with when it comes to cervical kyphosis and why it's a problem. So the normal alignment of the cervical spine or the neck should be a circular shape. It approximates the shape of a circle. Think of it like a C shape. So the face is facing that way, the back of the head's here. The neck should be a circular shape. I'll pop up an x-ray over here on the screen so you can see that, okay? And that's important because the spinal cord, which is the main connection from your brain to your entire body, is nice and loose in there. It's not being stretched or tethered. The actual joints are not being damaged or stretched. The ligaments are not being stretched. The discs are not being compressed with a normal cervical lordosis. Everything's nice and relaxed, and the neurology of the spinal cord and the integrity of the discs, the spine, the joints, the muscles are all intact and good. The problem is when there's a cervical kyphosis is that there's actually a reversal of that normal lordosis in the cervical spine. So that's what a kyphosis means. A kyphosis means bending in the forward position, okay? Now you can see that that's not good. And the consequences for a cervical kyphosis is, in the long run, will cause spinal degenerative disc disease and arthritis along the spinal joints and along the discs. The discs are now being compressed in this anterior forward position, and they're not designed to take that much weight. The spinal bones are not designed to take that much weight or load in the forward position. They're designed to take most of the weight in the reversed, in the correct posterior extension position. So the cervical kyphosis not only will lead to degenerative arthritis in the long run, but it will lead to chronic neck pain, it will lead to disability related neck pain, limited mobility, tightness in the muscles, inflammation, pain, and all sorts of symptoms that can result from affecting the spinal cord and nerve system up in this area here. So when this is detected on an x-ray, it's very important that it's corrected. And that's what this video is about, is to show you the corrective treatment for cervical kyphosis. Hi there, for those of you that haven't met me, I'm Dr. Walter Salubro. I'm a corrective care chiropractor in Vaughan, Ontario, Canada. And what this channel is about is giving you tips and strategies on how to strengthen, stabilize, and even correct your spine with non-surgical, non-operative corrective techniques. Also give you some stretches and tips on how to bend, move, and lift easier without pain and without limitation. So if you like this type of information, you want these tips and strategies, you want to learn about corrective chiropractic care, just subscribe right now by clicking on the subscribe button below, tap the notification bell. Let me know that you subscribe. Like this, I'll reply right back to you in the comments and give you a personal thank you. And like this, you won't miss out on any of this information on my channel. So I have my assistant here. His name is Sahej. He's my clinical technical assistant in my office. He helps me with all the patient setups and structural rehab that we do in our office. He's volunteered his time to be in the video, and I'm going to demonstrate these corrective protocols with him today. And the technique that I'm going to be applying today is called chiropractic biophysics. That's chiropractic biophysics, or CBP for short. I'm a trained and certified doctor in chiropractic biophysics, and I learned this technique from Dr. Dean Harrison down in Eagle, Idaho at the CBP Doctors Institute. And in the Greater Toronto Region, that's where I'm from, there's only 10 chiropractors that are certified in this technique. This technique, chiropractic biophysics, is backed up by over 300 research publications. So it's a well-researched, well-established, well-validated technique for structural rehabilitation of the spine. And that's what we're gonna be talking about today, is how to apply these corrective techniques, which is gonna be exercise, adjustments, and traction to a cervical kyphosis, okay? So in this technique, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna exercise the spine, okay? So let's take Sahej through some of these exercises. We always teach the patient to do some warm-up exercises to get the tissues warmed up, the muscles, the ligaments, the discs, to prepare the patient for the adjustment and also for the traction session. The warmer the tissues are and the ligaments are, the more pliable the spine will be and the easier the traction will be and the more it'll create changes on the spine. The whole goal with corrective chiropractic care is to create ligamentous changes. We want to create ligamentous creep deformation changes to restore the ligaments in the proper direction. So what that means is this. So the ligaments hold the spine together. The spine is a circular shape in the neck, just like this, from the lateral view, okay, from the side view. And the ligaments, the anterior ligaments here, the posterior longitudinal ligament on the inside, all the ligaments on the back, posterior part of the spine, they're all designed to bend in this curvy shape extending backwards, okay? So when there's a kyphosis, that original ligamentous alignment and structure got deformed in this bad position. So we literally have to retrain the spine, the ligaments, the discs, the muscles to change that, so to deform that and improve it into the better position this way. So you can imagine it's not gonna be an easy process. And in most cases, you're not gonna get a full correction of the cervical kyphosis. So you wanna reduce it and restore as much curve as possible in there, okay? So the whole point about this is to create a mirror image opposite effect. So if the cervical kyphosis is forward, you wanna create a mirror image input through exercise adjustments and through traction to get that cervical curve restored into that natural lordosis as much as possible. So that's the goal with the exercises, with the adjustments, and with the traction. So you'll see everything we're gonna do, okay? Everything we're gonna do is gonna design to prepare the spine and also move it into this lordotic position, okay? So let's start with the first exercise. Okay, so the first exercise we're gonna do is a range of motion exercise. So the purpose of the range of motion exercise is to get the spine more mobile, get it more flexible, break down scar tissue, and it just generally feels good. It helps with pain relief. So if you enjoyed that and you wanna now see the corrective care exercises for cervical kyphosis, go watch it right here, right now. Right there, right now to watch the corrective care exercises for cervical kyphosis.